Team communication has become more important since the pandemic happened in 2020, and I want to break down for you guys the top five team communication apps for this year. So first and foremost, Microsoft Teams is what I use for my real job. It's a really great application that has a lot of nice functionality. It integrates directly with chat. And the nice thing about Microsoft Teams is that the mobile app is actually really good. I've used it at work for a while now, and even though I have notifications off, it really does a good job of showcasing the functionality of the app in the same way. I actually had a day where my audio drivers were broken at work, and I used Microsoft Teams with mobile in order to get into meetings for the entire day, and it worked really well. So for the pricing, you'll see here that the free version has unlimited group meetings for up to 60 minutes. You can have a lot of people in every meeting. You get a little bit of cloud storage, and there's unlimited chat and stuff. I think it's really good for people who want to use Outlook overall as a business. There's obviously the Teams Essentials, where you'll get up to 30 hours of meetings, and then the really high level of stuff, you get like unlimited meetings and whatnot, and you can have team meetings recording with transcripts, and you'll also get something that's really nice, which is about a terabyte per user. So I think this $6 a month for businesses is really good. You'll have business emails with Outlook. You'll have all of the Microsoft suite. I would really recommend that this is an option for you guys. I think Teams has an amazing platform that gives you chat, video, audio, great mobile app, and a bunch of different apps and services. So in order to compare Microsoft to Google, we actually have to look at their Google Workspace business options. And what you'll actually see here is the pricing might be a little bit better for Microsoft, but what you get with Google is continuously improving. You have every single plan, including all these applications. And Google Chat is something that can work really well. If you like something like the Google environment, I think Google for Teams is getting really better, as I am somebody who personally is subscribed to the Google Workspace plan, the $12 a month one. I really like this business standard one. You have really great meeting integrations. I personally like the fact that if I go into my Google Calendar here, I have a weekly sync with Chance. I can click on my calendar really easily and join with Google Meet. The Google Calendar experience is something that you have to consider if you want to use Google Chat and the Google Workspace in general, because when you have something that is so good like Google Calendar, and personally I think it's better than Outlook, same with Gmail, this is something really to consider when going and looking at these different applications. The pricing is solid. 12 bucks a month per person is expensive, but you can definitely use the $6 a month one. You'll just have way less cloud storage than you would have had with Microsoft at the same option. So I've covered Slack before. The free application itself has a fair amount of searchable messages and integrations, but the thing is, it bought Woven Calendar, which is huge. So the calendar functionality on this is great. It has really great functionality with Google Calendar. You can do video and audio calls on this guy, and the application itself works really well and has a lot of integrations with things like Notion, Todoist, and many other productivity apps. So I would say that this is the best pure chat app on this list. While Microsoft Teams is pretty solid for it, and so is Google Chat, this is the best pure chat app on this list, and it has video and audio call options as well, which makes it very competitive. From a pricing standpoint, it is a little bit more pricey than something I personally think like the Google Suite. You know, you get like that meeting setup, you have all that different functionality with it, and while this can integrate with other things, it not being a little bit cheaper than the $12 a month plan that I'd get from Google makes it a little less like, I don't know if I really want to go with it. However, there are really nice options for like the enterprise level, I think, with this, you know, with HIPAA compliant messages and stuff. I personally have experienced businesses that need to have a high level of security. I know Microsoft has that option, and Slack seems to have an option for it as well. Now, if you're running a small team, I would really recommend checking out Twist from a pure chat app perspective, because it's $5 per user per month and you get unlimited everything. It integrates really nice with Todoist, which is a very basic task management app for a small business to run with. And overall, you'll just have to pay like $5 for this, and then a few more dollars a month for Todoist, and you'll have a really great team ecosystem there. However, it does have a limitation regarding, you can't have like an Outlook email really working with it too well. You'd have to use Google to go along with it for the email perspective and even the meetings perspective. So I would recommend this for teams that are smaller, but still looking for an option to communicate in what they like to call a calmer manner. I'm not really sure what they mean by it, because I've interacted with this and I think it looks great. I think it functions great. I think it has really good integrations, but they're saying it's like a calmer form of chat. Sometimes people just say marketing things and expect us to just kind of go with it. Last but not least, I actually have Discord on here. So Discord is a pretty much free service where you can interact with people in a really nice way. There is a big sort of gamer stigma that goes along with Discord, but if you think about what it has for you, like the different features, you can do video calls, you can do audio calls, you can have unlimited chat, all for free. I know people who have been gaming for years who have used Discord and have never appreciated how many years they have been using a platform and not had to pay anything for it. And there is an option called Discord Nitro where there's like cool benefits for a $9.99 monthly cost. Well, you'll have a bunch of like improvements on things like, you know, HD video and whatnot, but this is more of like a personal thing, less than a team thing. But honestly, chat communication for people who are in the gaming industry, this has been huge. But if a company wanted to, they could just have a really private Discord and have the same level of functionality regarding communication with each other. I know you wouldn't be able to have meetings in the same way, but this is an option that many people don't think about. And I think it's in my top five of chat communication apps in 2022. If you're interested in more ways to improve your productivity, check out this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.